Digital multiplayer in Gloomhaven is now here, but you still don't know how to play with your best buds. So let me show how you can now start playing multiplayer Gloomhaven with your friends. Let's check it out. As always, guys, if you do enjoy this video, please do toss it a like. It helps me out so much here on YouTube. And also consider subscribing if you like your Gloomhaven content. I've got lots more videos planned and lots of videos already made. So check out my channel description for more Gloomhaven videos. If you do have any questions you want to ask me in person, you can always catch me live at twitch.tv/mandatoryquest. I stream every Monday, Wednesday, and Sunday, so come hang out, talk Gloomhaven, and just say hi. Okay, let's just jump into it and what you're going to need to get started playing multiplayer in Gloomhaven Digital Guildmaster mode. First off, you're going to need all players who want to play have their own copy of Gloomhaven Digital on Steam. If that wasn't obvious. Next up, get everybody in a Discord or Zoom conference call. There are currently no in-game text or voice or pinging systems in place, so communication is key for Gloomhaven, so you're going to need to be able to chat. Gloomhaven's usually played with friends or with an arranged group anyway. It's not the kind of game where you're going to drop in and drop out. So I don't see this as a real negative to have no support for this currently, because to be honest, you're going to want to have to communicate over voice anyway. So I don't see it as much of a drawback. If you are looking for a group and you don't have a group yet, you can join our community Discord server. I'll put a link in the description below. There's a looking for group channel in there, and there's always people sort of online looking for people to play with. So jump in there and maybe you can find someone to play with. So once you have your players, you must make sure that all players have actually cleared the tutorial in Gloomhaven Digital first, either by skipping through this, you can do that if they're experienced players, or if they would maybe learn something, it might be worth them actually playing through the tutorial first. The tutorial is not multiplayer, so you can't play that element of the game in multiplayer at all. So just get them to go through that, jump through it. You get a little pop-up that comes up to say multiplayer is unlocked. A good way of creating a fresh save for multiplayer is just to skip the tutorial, use the skip tutorial option, and then basically you're straight in with a fresh save. I can't confirm if you actually need to do this if you're just joining the session and not hosting, but if you are new to Gloomhaven, definitely check out the tutorial. It's really, really good. So once you've done that, from here, the player who is going to be the main player, who's going to be able to be at every session or most of your sessions, should really be the host of the game. This is important because characters aren't movable between saves. Your characters live within that specific save, just like a tabletop campaign. You are playing as a collective group of guildmasters. You run the guilds together, not exclusively as a character like in the traditional Gloomhaven campaign. So your save will record all of the characters, all of the gold, all of the items, missions, just everything to do with that guild. Multiplayer works by all people basically joining and downloading a copy of that most recent save from the host. This means that when you actually finish the game, you will have a copy of that session's save. However, if you were then to split up and then say you wanted to level up one of your own characters on your own, you would then have to load from that save if you wanted to keep your progress. So that's why, really, you would probably want to actually just keep a multiplayer save separate from like a solo campaign, unless you were happy with people just dropping in and dropping out, sort of to keep up and being behind you and your progress that maybe you're making. Once you've hosted to join a session, you can either invite by Steam or by sending your unique game code to everyone. Then the joining players can then use this code through the join session button on the main menu to join your game. Personally, I like to use the game code method. I think it works really, really smart and seems to be really quick, but either way works here. Once players start to join your game, you'll get a notification, and then you will need to assign them to a slot in your game. Just like with tabletop Gloomhaven, there is a maximum of 4 players here, but you can assign multiple slots to the same player if you wanted to control more than one character each. Basically, each slot equals one character. Once all of these slots are selected, all players are then free to do pretty much whatever they like. They can swap characters, they can use the shop, they can visit the trainer, just like in single player. Currently, the only option for gold in multiplayer is shared though, which means that you need to have some level of trust. So just keep an eye on those scoundrel players in your party. Individual gold options will be coming in the future, but for Guildmaster, shared gold kind of makes more sense because you're working together as a single guild to kind of better and create a better guild. And you can all swap characters out with with each other anyway or transfer items. So, you know, buying a set of boots, for example, for a certain character is not as bad as perhaps it would be in the campaign if you were like, hey, you just used all my gold to buy that item for you. But I mean, in the next scenario, you could play that character, so it's not quite as bad. Still feels pretty rubbish sometimes when someone steals your gold, though, am I right? When you want to start a mission, all players just need to ready up, and then the host player can choose a mission. So you can just discuss this over comms, choose where you want to go, and the host player kind of gets final say, really. So the host player does all of the kind of going on missions, selecting the missions, and also if you get any road events that will pop up, you can discuss those like over communications or whatever, and then the actual host will need to make the final decision on that. Okay, so once you've done that and you get yourself to the start of the mission screen where you can select all of your cards again if you'd like, change your items and things. You can't swap out any mercenaries in this screen, they are locked in, so you'll have to play who you selected before you went on your journey. But you can change cards and things like that if you can see that certain enemy types are going to be present in the scenario and what the kind of goals of the scenario are. But then everyone readies up and then you're into playing normal Gloomhaven. So once you get into an actual mission, this functions exactly the same as tabletop Gloomhaven. It's you all simultaneously select your cards, and once everybody is ready, the round plays out with everyone taking their turns just like normal. There is no timer here, so you can bug your friend who's taking a long time to take their turn. There is no timer though, so you can take as long as you want to discuss things and just work out what it is that you want to do. This is pure Gloomhaven as you know and love it if you've played the board game version. One small missing feature is the battle goals. So these will be featured later on in the campaign mode when that's released as normal. However, they aren't going to be in Guildmaster mode. These have actually been replaced by the trainer achievements and by the individual character story missions. These will allow you to unlock the additional perk points that you can get, and also you can get extra gold by doing the different achievements and things like that. So they've just been replaced because in Guildmaster mode, the battle goals didn't feel like they really fit with the general theme, and I can see that there. You do lose a little bit of interaction here because instead of now you maybe having some conflicting goals with your teammates as you are moving through the level, you kind of always want to be working together with Guildmaster, and there are higher levels of difficulty available in this mode too. So if you really wanted to give yourself a challenge, just crank the difficulty up, because man, is it tough to play on insane when you don't have control of every single character, trust me. Also, remember that gold is shared, so you don't necessarily have to compete so much over who's gonna get the gold. But, I mean, let's face it, everyone always wants to get gold anyway, so the passive-aggressive gold getting is gonna happen regardless. But it's all going in the same pocket, so I suppose you can let the scoundrel off a little bit more for that, but still, they're going to run around and be greedy, right? If you are new to Gloomhaven in general, you might not be aware of the communication rules that exist in the tabletop version. So this is essentially saying that you're not allowed to mention numbers or very specific parts of your turn to other players when you're selecting your cards. This is just so that you can't have perfect information to kind of like stop there being too much like analysis paralysis of players, you know, trying to think through like, well, if that player does this, this player does that, then this enemy moves here. It's to try and allow the game to sort of flow more freely and to kind of like represent the fact that you wouldn't know what your sort of teammates are doing if you're all simultaneously selecting your actions, right? You wouldn't have perfect information there. So the best way of doing it is just to not use things like numbers or specifics. So it's fine to say something like, I'm going to go early and I'm going to attack that bandit. Like that, in my opinion, is absolutely fine. Some people may disagree, might say that saying that bandit is too much, but I think that's okay. But I wouldn't say it was okay to say I'm going to attack that bandit with an attack 3 and I'm going to go on initiative 10. Like that would be, you know, against the rules, because I've said way too much. As soon as you start bringing values into the scenario, that's when it kind of starts getting a bit wrong for me. However, it's up to you how you want to play this. This is like an informal rule now that we're talking about digital, right? There's no way that the game can enforce this with you. So just play however you feel comfortable to play. Some groups will want to play this really strict, some will not want to play it hardly at all, if at all. There are more levels of difficulty inside Gloomhaven Digital, so you can crank the difficulty way up, and in that case you will need to be able to sort of talk a bit more with your team, I would say, to have any chance, because when you're playing on insane difficulty with four player multiplayer, I mean, you make one wrong move and you're probably going to lose the scenario. So, you know, you really do have to communicate very well. If you are used to playing tabletop Gloomhaven, then unfortunately there are no takesies backsies in digital Gloomhaven. There's no undo button, there's no way for you to drag the game back, unfortunately. So really do take the time with your turn by selecting your cards and things. Don't do like what I do all the time, which is I constantly forget to use my stamina potions on my turn. I know that usually it would be like, oh, okay, let's just, I would have used my stamina potion there. I just forgot at the end of my turn. You can't do that here, folks. So just make sure that you are concentrating and that you're kind of in the game, right? There's no undo button. You're just going to have to live with your choices, I'm afraid, which, you know, sometimes makes for quite an interesting game because you keep screwing up. So there's always that. I did want to squeeze a quick note about spoilers into this video. So spoilers in Guildmaster mode, the only real spoilers are the unlockable characters and the items, in my opinion. There's only one unlockable character currently available in Gloomhaven Digital, which is the Triangles class. There is also the music note coming very soon, and then the devs are going to be kind of ramping up the release of them all the way up until when the campaign will come out sometime next year. Personally, I don't think that that's a big spoiler if you're quite deep into the game. If you played the game quite a bit, these spoilers are probably pretty minor for you, like some extra items and stuff. I mean, the items in general, there are some items that will surprise you, but most of the items are kind of like, you once you start to unlock a few of the items, right, you kind of get a general sense of what kind of items are available to you. So I wouldn't be too worried about that. And then it's really is just the unlockable classes. So you're just going to have to weigh that up for yourself personally. Is that an issue for you? If not, then you can kind of crack on and start playing. And I think this is a really great way to enjoy that kind of core Gloomhaven gameplay experience, but without actually touching upon the physical story that the board game tells, which is a great story, and I'm really looking forward to that being integrated as well. So that wraps up today's video. If you did enjoy the video, consider tossing it a like, guys. It does help me out so much. And consider subscribing. We've just passed 500 subscribers on the channel, which is just mind-blowing to me. The next milestone is 1,000. If we can get to 1,000, I mean, I don't know what I'll do, but I'll have to make some sort of crazy video, I guess. So consider subscribing if you enjoy the videos. And I've got more Gloomhaven videos planned. And also, I've got plenty to watch as well on my channel. So check them all out. If you have any questions you want to ask me live, you can always catch me at twitch.tv/mandatoryquest. I stream there every Monday, Wednesday, and Sunday, usually Gloomhaven. But I'm always down to talk Gloomhaven if it's something else. So just come by, say hi, and yeah, hang out. And don't forget, there is a link in the description below for our community Discord server. So if you're looking for other people to play Gloomhaven with, maybe you can find some people in there. But apart from that, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will catch you next time. Bye.
There's going to be a couple of guys in that, I think.
Yeah. Are you using insider dev knowledge? Hacks? Dev hacks?
Hacks.
Hacks. Well, you know exactly how many enemies are going to be in that room. Yeah, that's fine with that. Metagaming? Yeah. Overmind says he needs to rest next turn, probably. I think we'll probably all be pretty synced.
Begin real life? Or... Yeah. Whoa, that's a lot. I was like, there's not going to be many guys in there. Oh no, that's a lot of guys. Man, these are... Yeah. This might cause problems.
I mean, if I can get in with an unstable upheaval, you know, all is well. I can wipe out the entire room in one attack. Well, if I had goggles, I could.